السلام عليكم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. I am Ahmed Ghraib from University College of Applied Sciences, UCAS. My paper entitled Computer-based Detection of Glaucoma using Fundus Image Processing. First of all, let's talk about glaucoma. It is called also the sneak of sight. It is a disease that affects the human eye. It is a major cause of blindness globally. It damages the optic nerve cells that transmit visual information to the brain. So there is a real need to automate the detection process of glaucoma using different features like cup-to-disc ratio and Eisenst ratio. In this slide, we can see the fundus image, which is the image of the retina of the human eye. Here is the optic nerve, which contains the optic cup and the optic disc areas. The optic cup is the center of the optic nerve, as we can see here. And the optic disc is the surrounding area of the optic cup. Here are different shapes of the optic disc and the optic cup from different fundus images. We can see how it is difficult for the doctors to determine these areas. Mainly, it is subject to the opinion of the doctors. So we will solve this problem by automating the detection of the optic cup and the optic disc areas. At this slide, we mentioned two types of glaucoma. We will not discuss these two types, but we will talk about the main common feature for these two types, which is the sudden severe pain that happens for the patient. Sometimes, blindness can occur in a matter of days and no symptoms in early stages. Our methodology depends on two main features to detect glaucoma, which are used by doctors. They are cup-to-disc ratio and Eisenst ratio. Let's talk about the first feature, which is the cup-to-disc ratio. As we can see, it is the ratio between the optic cup area and the optic disc area. In ordinary people, it varies from 0 to 0.87. Cup-to-disc ratio that is greater than 0.65 is considered to be suspicious for glaucoma. Here you can see the difference between the healthy optic nerve and the optic nerve in eye with glaucoma. We will use these steps to extract cup-to-disc ratio. We have explained it in this diagram or in this picture. First of all, we will consider the red channel for the extracting of disc area and the green channel for extracting the cup area. Why? Because the disc area is more clearer in the red channel and the cup area is more clearer in the green channel. We will remove the noise in the image pre-processing step here in this step. And after that, we will remove the vessels or the blood vessels using morphological operations. Then we will threshold the output of this step using two different threshold values for the red and for the green channels. Finally, we will crop the region of interest area and then we calculate the cup-to-disc ratio. Here is the pre-processing step, which include noise reduction, smoothing, and contrast enhancement. Finally, generating the region of interest mask. This is the step of blood vessels removing. As we can see here, the result. No blood vessels here. Using morphological operations, opening and closing operations. For the optic disc segmentation, we face different challenges. Optic disc can be recognized as one candidate of exudates. This is the major challenge we have faced. If we look at this picture or this fundus image, we can see that there is different exudates in different areas of the fundus image, which can be recognized as optic disc maybe. So this is one of the main challenges that we have faced. As we can see here, we used a threshold of 3 times of the standard deviation of the red channel in order to extract the optic disc from the red channel. And here we used 4 times of the standard deviation of the green channel in order to extract the optic cup from the green channel, as we can see here. In this step, we just filling the cup area using the best fit circle algorithm in order to get a circular shape of the optic cup. Finally, we calculate the cup to disc ratio using this equation. And this is one of the results of the extraction of the cup and the disc. Now we will talk about the isent ratio. The isent ratio depends on the isent rule, which states that in normal eyes, the thickness of the rim in the inferior is the widest, and then the superior, and then the nasal, and then the temporal. That's why we called it isent rule. I stands for inferior, S stands for superior, nasal, and temporal. So the isent ratio is calculated using the total amount of vessels in the I and S to the total amount of vessels in N plus T. So in order to measure the isent ratio for the fundus image, we should use four masks for the disc photograph. Then the ratio of the sum of blood vessels area in the inferior and superior quarters to the sum of the blood vessels in the nasal and temporal quarters should be calculated to find isent ratio. These are the steps that we have used to extract isent ratio. We will show it in this diagram. First of all, we take the green channel, and then we determine the optic disc, which is the region of interest for our methodology to extract isent ratio, using the previously described optic disc extraction method in this slide and in this paper. After that, we will use a bottom hat transfer to extract the dark areas from the cropped optic disc. Then we threshold this picture to extract vessels. What is the bottom hat transfer? The bottom hat transfer simply is a methodology to return an image that containing elements that are smaller than the structuring element and darker than their surroundings. As we can see here in this picture, you can see how we extracted the blood vessels using the bottom hat transfer to extract the darker areas from this image. The result of the cup to disc extraction method, we have compared our results with respect to the manual segmentation done by our colleague, Dr. Wissam Shahada from King Abdullah University Hospital in Erbil from Jordan. We noted that our method to extract cup to disc ratio is near the results of the manual cup to disc ratio with a standard deviation that is close to each other. As you can see here, this is the manual results done by Dr. Wissam, and this is the machine results done by our algorithm. You can see the difference is too small between the average and the standard deviation. In this chart, we can see the cup to disc error distribution analysis between the machine and the manual calculations. Here, the manual cup to disc ratio, and this is the cup to disc ratio error. You can see that the error rate is low and the standard deviation also is low. Isent ratio extraction results. We have used the t-test, so we divided the samples into two groups. The first one is the normal group, which contains 100 normal images, and the second one is the glaucoma group, which contains 13 images. Isent ratio is calculated for each sample, and we applied the t-test calculations, which includes the p-value. So we calculated the p-value, and we found it equals to 0.0009, which is below the value of 0.05, which is the value that is used to be sure that the two groups are different and can be distinguished using isent rule. So this value indicates that the isn't ratio is statistically and clinically significant and can be used to detect glaucoma. As you can see here, the results from the normal images different, and there is a big difference between the normal images and the glaucoma images. Finally, as a conclusion, we concluded that optic disc and optic cup automatic segmentation method is used with an average successful recognition rate of 96 for the optic disc and about an average of 83 for the optic cup. So the optic cup methodology need to be improved more. And the isn't ratio is significant and can be used to detect glaucoma using other features also like optic disc and optic cup calculations. We can use also these calculations in order to make an artificial intelligence system and classification with other features, not only the cup to disc and isn't ratio. We can maybe use other features in order to classify glaucoma and normal images clearly. Thank you very much for your attention and for your listening.